mics, please? Mark, are you good? You're live? Awesome. Go ahead, you're live.
Welcome, everybody, to the Anna Broom Room. Anya, my dear friend, just brought me this bracelet she made for me. Just want to show everybody how beautiful that is. Nothing like gifts someone makes for you. I want to say that for a year...
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Art Share. I'm Cheyenne. I've been graced by Anna for the past year. I started here about a year ago yesterday. And Anna Broom Room has bought... Thank you. Thanks. Aww. Anna has done nothing but celebrate this community in a way that Art Share appreciates, and that's what we're here for. Broom Room has brought talents from all walks of life, all over LA, here onto this stage, and it just gets better and better every year, every month. So now that we've hit 1 year, it's going to get better and better every year. So I'm so excited to have her here tonight and to celebrate your talents and to celebrate her amazing production value. On with the show.
Well, now I'm weepy. We are going to go ahead and start. Even though we're not full, we will be. We know how it works. It is LA, so if you say it's 8 p.m., everybody gets here at 9 o'clock, and you congratulate them for being early. I'd like to acknowledge that my family is here and have always been supportive of me in all of my art endeavors, including all the art endeavors of everyone in our family, and what a gift and blessing that is. I'm sure they'd rather me have stuck to the chemistry degree, but here we are. Miss Fanny, we're going to introduce one of my favorite people, not only in LA or at Art Share, a part of the Broom Room, but just one of my favorite people I know to be alive. That is because she has struggled her whole life and has the most positive attitude of anyone I've ever known. And every time I see her, I am grateful to know her, and I know that's a rare thing in any person. She's also a gifted singer, a wonderful poet, a great friend, and a member of our community. Will you please welcome to the stage the beautiful, the wonderful, the talented Fanny Mayfield.
Hello, everybody. I'm here to honor Anna Broom's 1 year anniversary tonight. Anna is a great friend of mine. She's a sister. She's a blessing in the wind. When I first met Anna here at Art Share, I did my first poem and I sung a song. And she walked up to me. She said, "What do you need?" I said, "What I need?" I said, "What do you need?" And I said, "Everything." She said, "Let's go. We're going to go to the brewery and we're going to eat dinner right now." And I said, "Wow, nobody's never came up to me and done that before." Anna is, she's awesome. She's great in this community. I mean, she loves everybody. She's funny, she's smart, and when I was diagnosed with breast cancer in the third stage, and I met Anna, and she said, "Don't worry about a thing. Everything is going to be all right. Whatever you need, we're here for you." And man, she touches my heart all the time. She's great. She's great. I don't know. I know what I would do if anything if she would ever leave anything, I would go on with the blessings that she has given me. I just want to tell you this. Anna, you are great. In your heart, don't be late. Take your wings and just fly away. In my heart, you are great. You're my friend. Don't be late. In your heart, take your wings and fly away. I love you, Anna. Friendship, friendship. What a perfect friendship. I love you, Anna. Don't you be late. In my heart, you are great.
Let's all say thank you to Fannie Mayfield. Don't you make me cry at my own show ever again, Fannie. Big trouble. Let's say thank you to Mark Walsh, who tirelessly contributes to this neighborhood. He is live streaming this right now as a part of LA Art Stream. Let's give an applause to him. Let's say thank you to Stephen Brooks, who's doing our siding and lighting and sound. And he's with me all day helping me get through the stuff, and he deserves an award for that. I have a cute little sassy band coming on next. This little dude and gal good duo, who I just love and I have in the broom room often. I appreciate them for all their contributions. Please welcome to the stage. Will you please come here, my darlings? Pistachio Novella.
Oh, is the mic working? Yay! Okay. Yeah. We're three tonight. Cynthia Gordon on bass. And Rafael Patricio with his really awesome new guitar. Go into the light, Cynthia.
Okay, I guess sound-wise, we should be okay. Oh, wait.
I'm sorry. I need this.
This is live, coming at you guys. It wouldn't be a Pistachio Novella performance if there wasn't quirks, so thanks for putting up with us.
Okay. we go. I'm going to try this again. In a fool's game, we were making up all the rules. We were wasted, we were drinking up all our dreams. Come my way, turn me on, bring me out on your way. Come my way, turn me on, bring me out on your way. We were just like fools in love, chasing all our dreams away. Come away, turn me on, burn me out on your way. When the songs played, we would dance away all our pain. With our best friends, we would sing until the break of day. Come my way, turn me on, bring me out on your way. Come my way, turn me on, bring me out on your way. We were just like fools in love, chasing all our dreams away, wishing on another day, just to wish the pain away. Come my way, turn me on, burn me out on your way. Come my way, turn me on, burn me out on your way.
In our fool's games, we were making up all the rules.
We were wasted, we were drinking up all our dreams.
Come away, turn me on, burn me out on your way.
Come my way, turn me on, burn me out on your way. Come my way, turn me on, burn me out on your way. Come my way, turn me on, burn me out on your way.
Come away, turn me on, burn me out on your way.
Thank you. Okay. About 2 years ago, we kind of put this little project together, me and Melissa. And it's been about 2 years, I guess. I guess we talked about it, and it was like the autumn of 2012, and you know, it's been fun doing this, you know. So anyway, this song is called
"You and I."
Yeah, that's the name of the song. 1, 2, 3, 4. Autumn leaves around my feet again. Do you remember that fall, my friend? You and I were the only ones, the only ones to follow the sun. Do you remember?
remember. Yesterday is on my mind. Time isn't mine. Never knew what you and I could find. When I was making my own plans, you went and became your own man. I couldn't believe you'd abandon me after all the things you and I had seen. Was I seeing things? Yesterday is on my mind. Time isn't mine. You never knew what you and I could find. We were just like beams of light fading in the grass. Sad to think the dreams we shared have all been turned to glass. Tracing the pathways on our own, burning the bridges to keep us warm. Feels like home even when we're alone, no matter how far in this life we roam. We were here, we were here. We were here.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. We're Pistachio Novella, and we've got one more song.
The winter grows too cold, dear. I'm not myself. What was is fading from me? Who is that girl? A sickness lies within me, too gone to cure. Take heart, go on without me. I'll only be a burden to you. The night goes on. The night goes on. Morning comes again, but it still feels dark. So sudden the terror strikes, and I can't get up. Take heart, go on without me. I'll only be a burden to you. No man's an island, they say, but this woman's doomed. The night goes on. The night goes on. I may not see the good in me, but for you I'll keep on fighting.
They're getting their equipment together. I'm going to say a few things. First, it's been a long year, but a very fun one. We've lost friends. We've gained new friends. I want to say thank you to a few people. I want to say thank you to Jason Pippin, who live paints for me all the time. He's a beautiful... He's not painting right now. But he's a great talent. It's been wonderful to watch him develop that talent and to extend himself as he does here tonight. So a round of applause. Thank you to Sean Tyne. He's always been a friend. I'm going to welcome someone to the stage now who, when I started this class, I started a poetry class at ArtShare. I received a grant for that. And one of my students is here tonight to read her Villanelle, which was her homework for this evening, because I'm still giving her homework after all this time. She's very good at form poetry, so I encourage her to work more toward that. And will you please welcome to the stage with enthusiasm the grace, the talent, the wonderful nature who is Zoe Grace.
Okay, for some reason I am good at that. I can just do this for some reason. It's kind of fun. She said you have to write a villanelle. And basically the villanelle has like stanzas and they have to rhyme and all this kind of stuff. So it was actually a lot of fun to do it. Okay. Well, right now it's untitled, but I think it'll be something like titled something called like Freedom Cry, something like that. Okay. Freedom, cry freedom, freedom cry. We're not to say just what we think, but breaking down, those walls we fly. The wrong, it makes the heart awry, twisted in pain, nearing the brim. Freedom, cry freedom, freedom cry. Time we lose in pretense, we sigh. Silent order, we are in sync, but breaking down those walls, we fly. So locked in closet, nowhere high, life's charades make hellions wink. Freedom, cry freedom, freedom cry. Life's games unreal, living a lie. The strong, the good, make bad ones shrink. Freedom, cry freedom, freedom cry. The breaking down those walls, we fly.
People always ask, at what point will I take off my shoes? And I say, being born in Tennessee, I was never properly introduced to them. I prefer to have them not on, if you don't mind. Now, I met this girl at Lee Beck Show. If everyone is aware of Lee Beck Show, Story File, every first Thursday of the month here at Art Chair. Also a wonderful, eclectic group of performers. But I heard her read her poetry to guitar. And I thought she was so enchanting and interesting and unique. And then I read her book of poetry, and she became even more interesting and unique. Please welcome to the stage the most awesome, unique talent, as all the talents this evening are. But here is Yvonne de la Vega.
You rock. And a room rocks, right? Right?
Yeah.
I love that laugh. No, she really does. She rocks. Probably one of the best poetry art hosts in Los Angeles. And I should know, I am the Los Angeles Poetry Examiner. Okay. Not only do I get free books from people, but I write reviews. this is my book. We went all the way home to go get it. The pages are falling out in my copy. And this one. Yeah. I was going to play the guitar because the heat, you know, the heat kind of messes with your wooden instruments. And, but Anna asked me to please do one. Does anybody live in the valley?
No.
Okay. God bless you. It's so hot. It's like so. It's like oppressively hot. It's, oops. I don't like indigo either. I just want you to know. Thank you. Okay. So this plugs in, I think. If you have a... Okay, we're live streaming? Okay.
Oh, yes.
All right.
You're the head of the world right now,
bro. That's right, you are. Live streaming. I met Pony in the pool hall. Over by the player's house phone they had for our incoming calls. It was a 3-minute limit. Him fresh from a year in a jail cell, me broken hearted and in love still. We played 9-ball trying to forget. And I loved Pony Boy. I loved him just like a little brother. He was a gambler, raced to 3 for 10. First he'd play real bad, and then he'd start playing like a motherfucker. We were violin angels in purgatory. That place of old saints, this their glory, where everybody knew everybody's story and everybody's game. One day, Pony Boy, he gets 86'd for 100 phone calls from 100 chicks. House thought he was a dope dealer. I knew that he had 9 months of sobriety. So Pony Boy, he goes back out on the streets. And I would say, run, Pony, and I would pray. He was last seen boxing it out with the prisoners of crack hell down by Wilcox Alley. Fallen angel, searching for the innocence gone too long. to take the blame. The sacred spirals of heaven's winds you cannot light upon with the demon in your vein. And so you go down, 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 and then you're 3 days gone. You're gone and falling down, broke your crown. Golden sobriety, frail-legged pony, step by step. He's wandered too close to the edge of the darkened valley. His mom watches the telephone, and his dad acts like he's watching the TV. And they don't know they're not to blame, but their hearts search family history. And they watch you go down, and then you're 10 days now. You've gone and fallen down, broke your crown, golden sobriety. And they can't call every hospital, and they don't know all your friends. And they can't call every station in the county, so instead they watch you go down. Yeah, and then you're so far gone. You've gone and fallen down, broke your crown, golden sobriety. Well, it's 5 years later, it's Friday night. The old pool hall shut down, it's saints and angels forced to take flight. We start playing on sunsets, all right. It's all about the game, it's about the night. And then someone says, hey, did you hear about Pony? And time stood still, and I said, no, no, don't tell me. Closed my eyes, I went running in the night. Fallen angels in purgatory, that place of old saints, this their glory, where everybody knew everybody's story and everybody's game. And my fallen angel searching for the innocence gone too long to take the blame.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm really happy to be here on your anniversary day. I feel special, dude. Thank you so much for having me.
Everybody, what a great talent. We are fortunate to be able to witness all these great people performing for us. Let's give everybody a hand.
We can be even more enthusiastic about it.
Okay, so I hear there's this new president of La Raba. This brilliant woman who is a great talent, she's a great poet, she's a part of our community, our neighborhood. She encourages me, she came to my show, I mean to my class rather, and was a guest speaker. She's a part of everything Art District. And we are so fortunate to have her reading with us tonight. She has published many books. She is, I would say, nationally recognized. And would you please bring welcome to the stage with so much honor, I'm so grateful she's here, the poet, the member of our community, Deborah Meadows.
Thank you. John Keats' Living Hand is behind us, and of course,
you're on Boardwalk Web.
course, this was found as a margin note, and it's an idea of poetry came through this hand, but it's also reaching into the future to you, to us, and here we are, right? I thought the three poems, I would start with two segments from also an elegiac poem, a poem of loss, Growing Still. When is the image a retort to technique, narrative paired to display case covered forces involved, layers, time, great pressure, substrate ingredients, hard not to imagine motive, plot toward development, restlessness, life below impact craters, water in wrong containers brought to impromptu shelters hung like a scene, a moral of human worth. The mind goes preceded by narrative trope, conducted elsewhere, a pose or cry, freighted with new economy of consequence, or does the body inhabit classical grief based on musculature and limits? Increased snow and interference, the pavement, the presence of rhyme, case-hardened artifice presents itself, lays a claim to heart's natural beat. They lost us for now. How might distance collapse? Matched parts move from increased set to assembly, a bins of yous and theys snap into a whole product, another mentality, disc grinder to smooth difference to metal flake, a complete car by Wednesday, spokes gleaming. Unbroken youngest sister carries bottles freshly filled to decorate an ancient face with an effort at kinship, to repeat the oldest action is solemn repetition. Water runs, people run water, time runs. When mechanism breaks, exposing metallic frailties, linguistic theory seems effete with its untouchable grandeur of disconnection, cultural illusion. Efferent, basics could trickle to dearth, its enlarged plans, rubble foundations. Having captured the mind of another, set off beyond unlikely seafoam monument, anti-plinth, dusty area boiling with small animals, their burrow holes by one dirt freshly turned and entranced consciousness. To write so that years later you can't recall the diaristic particulars of that day, recapture only a sense, a fractured tooth touched again and again, too sharp, too irregular to let consciousness pass and its ghostly hall walk to sleep on the white bed beyond the small door frame, it's time. Left alone, waterfront skyline, disrupted by cranes praying mantis overreach, by cable's steady line, it promised to spark better ways to everything. Had we eaten of the fruit, knew nakedly we could not stand to read another, the resurrected form videotaped in mine was not yet death, nor its subsequent chant of duration. The old neighborhood, winter wind perpetually whistling through walls, how some homes had a hopelessness even in youth. Having torn the membrane between one and many, the portrait takes part in tradition, representation of absent people. This week's new insect hatched after consistency of high temperatures that mean nothing. I'm going to move on to... On a lighter note, a few epigrams. Epigrams don't take up much paper or tombstone space. Unlike our neighbors, we are dogless heathens. They're from the country and live within a stone's throw of stones. What is it about the desire to excel at yogic self-mastery? Beside the freeway, a sign of programmable bulbs reads, "Texting while driving is against the law," all in the form of a text message. Have you ever noticed that aphorisms highlight contradictions? At work, everyone gets along and is united until management requires us to evaluate each other's work. Thank you.
My mother. attractive?
Emma, hi, Mom. I'm listening to your advice.
I have a great friend coming up to the stage. I think he's awake. Miles, are you with us? Anytime I ask Miles to play, and I want to say anytime I've asked anybody to be a part of the show, whether we had the grant and we had funding or we didn't, people came and performed with their whole hearts. And that's what the Art District is about. Such an example can be demonstrated in the wonderful saxophone playing of Miles Jackson. And another round of applause, please, for Deborah Meadows. What a rare treat that was. Thank you, Deborah.
How's everybody doing? Everybody okay? Okay, no problem. Before I get started, could somebody give me a glass of water? I'm a bit on the dry side right now. I'm going to put the microphones to the side because I sound better without a mic. Because my voice can be heard from here all the way to Salt Lake City. I did a show over there not too long ago. It was great.
I ran as fast as I could.
Sweet, thank you. You're sweet, thank you so much.
You want me to put the cat back on?
Oh, I can. Okay, let me go ahead and get busy here. I want to play a little jazz for you. These first two tunes may be known to you all, so let me get busy. Give yourselves a hand. You guys really uplifted me when I played. Thank you. Okay, for the last piece in my part of the program, do we have any Beatles fans in the house? Okay, I'm gonna remember that. Okay, I have all the Beatles albums in import and domestic, thanks to Amoeba Records in Hollywood. This one is my particular favorite, which is sung by Sir Paul McCartney, and I'll play it for you right now.
Deborah Meadows has also brought us a beautiful selection of poetry books on the back table. They are free. She has brought you wonderful pieces of beautiful writing to share in your, with yourself and others. Please go and look at the back table and choose whichever you like.
on the NYSE, nor were donations set aside by anonymous benefactors. No bogus or fraudulent accounts were established in advance and without your knowledge. Secretly structured by organized poets like me, determined the separation from your grief by suggesting that my poetry is strong, that its value is not overinflated, and that it is worth listening to. Later, I will doctor the records, but only after it is concluded that my poetry resonated with misleading information and under investigation included such words suggesting fraudulent activity, which I may not agree with, but believe was missed by an outside consulting firm. Finally, in a court of law, I will claim and inform you that I was ignorant of such transactions. I have no knowledge of this activity and cannot recall if I've been writing poetry whatsoever.
You may conclude from this that I am stupid for suggesting that you are as dumb as me. But I will agree with you, those responsible should pay and be held accountable for their actions.
A dear friend, that's who I can welcome to the stage next. I have many in this room, and I'm so grateful for you all. Can I say that without seeming too emotionally trite? No. Do I care? No. Sometimes you're the loudest laugh in the room, Brad Wallace. Please welcome to the stage the wonderful musical renderings of Eddie Reed.
Everybody.
She played me from a money man, she made me blue. A man needs a woman he can lean on, by my leaning post is done left and gone. Yes, he's gone and high. Lonesome blue. Man, I tell you. Man, it's cold as ice. And when I get to that river, that gal, she's gonna pay a price. Good God, I'm going down in it three times, but Lord, I'm only coming up twice. Yeah, she's long gone in time. Hang on, girls. We're almost there. Come on. What's the time limit on this?
You can go as long as you want.
Well, as long as I am, I guess. Peter, what's up, dog? Lightning. Man, I'm in deep water now. Okay. This is an all-star show. Let's see. Well, I intended to come and do murder ballads.
Yeah, one.
Yeah, well, that was the first. That was the first one.
Oh, can I get senior?
He killed himself. But now we're... Down in the willow garden, me and my love did meet. We were there courting when my love fell off to sleep. I drank a bottle. My love, she did not know. So I poisoned that dear, dear girl there on the banks below. I drew my saber through her. It was a blood. I laid her in the river. That was a peaceful sight. Father often has told me how money could set me free. For I did murder a dear, dear girl whose name is Father. Waits by his cabin door, drying his tear-filled eyes. Soon his son shall walk to yonder scaffold high. My race is run beneath the sun. The scaffold now calls for me. I go to meet a dear, dear girl whose name is
Thank you. Thank you so much, everybody. One more? I got to give this one a little intro. Okay, that first one, you're right. It was by Hank Sr. And that was, you know, somebody. These are murder ballads, right? So that was him. That was, we had to start it off on an up note. And that's about as low. That last one is about as low as we go tonight, I hope.
Oh, go lower.
Okay. Well.
You can go much lower.
No kissing and telling now. Anyway, yeah, the first one was, you know, self-murder. That last one was, you know, that was just killing, I don't know, your sweetie when you're a teenager or something. These stories go way back. They weren't really written by anyone. They were written by all of us. And this last one is by a songwriter that immigrated to the United States in the 40s from Trinidad. And this song went on to become a number one hit on the R&B charts in 1946 and number six on the Billboard charts for Louis Jordan and Ella Fitzgerald. I lie dead in the market, I'm stone cold dead in the market. I'm lying dead in the market, she killed me, I was her husband. Last night I went out drinking, I came home, I gave her the beating. So she catch up the rolling pin and went to work on my head till she bossed it in. I'm lying dead in the market, stone cold dead in the market. I'm lying dead in the market, she killed nobody but her husband. She licked me with the pot and the frying pan. She licked me with the pot and the frying pan. She licked me with the pot and the frying pan. And she said, I had it coming. Oh, I'm lying dead in the market, stone cold dead in the market. I'm lying dead in the market, she killed me, I was her husband. My family, they're swearing to kill her. My family, they're swearing to kill her. My family, they're swearing to kill her. And she said, I had it coming. Ooh, I'm lying dead in the market, stone cold dead in the market. I'm lying dead in the market, she killed nobody but her husband. Now there's one thing that is sure, I ain't going to beat her no more. And I tell you that I doesn't care if she go to die in the electric chair. Oh, I'm dying in the market, child, lying stone cold dead in the market, murder. Lying dead in the market, she killed nobody but her husband. Hey, child, I'm coming back to bash your head one more time. She said, no, no, man, you can't do that. I'm lying dead in the market, child, stone cold dead in the market, she's the criminal. Lying dead in the market, she killed nobody but her husband. And approve, everybody. And a boom boom, 1 year.
Eddie Ring!
kill you later. Whether you're my husband or not. This living hand, now warm and capable of earnest grasping, what if it were in the icy silence of the tomb? So haunt thy days and chill thy dreaming nights. Thou wish thy own soul dried of blood, so conscience can be calmed again. See, here it is. I hold it toward you. Mr. John Keats. What Brenda Hurst has done for us here, and when I told her that we were featuring John Keats, is that she has put a collection of his work on this canvas. Now, what she has done for you is at the end of the show, we have scissors. You can chop off any piece you want. Let's take a look. Oh, no dibs. Sean, it's not signed, man. Not by you, not yet. We have the poem I just recited here. Oh, thank you. Jason is going to pull a Vanna White. We like that. Go ahead, Jason. Take your piece. And I'm talking about the poetry.
Which one was it, Brenda, that we liked so much? You want to come help me? Let's say a few of them.
My imagination is a monastery, and I'm its monk.
The air is all softness.
I like this one.
Oh, wait, I heard. I heard melodies are sweet, but those unheard are sweeter. May that apply to me? Let's hope not.
Thou art a dreaming thing, a fever of thyself.
Thou art a dreaming thing, a fever of thyself. If you're interested in John Keats or the Romantic movement, the mid-1800s, England and the United States and all over the world, please enjoy. These are poets who enjoyed the imagination, the idea of self, victory over all, and that nature and man were as one, unless you're talking about Emerson and who wants to go there. Calm down. Calm down. Come here. Go home. Nothing further. Please welcome to the stage. One other thing great about our community is that we actually had children grow up here. How cool is that? I don't see many of the adults surviving, so the fact that children were raised here and became amazing parts of this community as well says something about the community itself. And Lightning Woodcock, who has often been a part of this show, who always shows up and rocks the house, but guess what, people? It's in the damn gene pool. Because his son does too. And his son rocks his own way and has his own spirit. And that's part about being in the art district. Will you please welcome to the stage, Wolf Woodcock.
Hands tied, tumbling gray.
eat hearts, and I like throwing rocks at dogs, but darling, I love you. I love you like the moon and stars when little kids get hit by cars. Girl, you know it's true. Darling, I love you. I've been trying to move on since you left, since you've been gone, but it's so hard on me.
Here this evening, it's been a great show. We have three more acts to perform, and then we're going to bid you good night. But let's bring up somebody who is hiding in the corner and thinks that I have telepathy beyond my own abilities I congratulate myself for. Wrongly. Please welcome to the stage. That's all I'm going to say, man. Brian Trainum, you want to come up here, please? Come on! You know this man.
She does have telepathy, correct? No, right? So I just sat there and she did. She found me. It's fucking funny. I am a transplant, but I am LA now. And I should know how this works. All right. Thank you. Yeah. I'm just nervous. Acid saved my life. If it wasn't for acid, I'd probably be divorced with three kids and miserable, like all the friends I grew up with high school. And I'm not saying that because I don't know. They tell me they're miserable. And they say I'm living the dream, but I'm just not sure. She picked up on my vibe. I looked at her and said, she said, what are you, surprised? I said, hell yeah, what are you doing here? She said, kid, I'm the much, much more. I'm the much, much more on that sign outside. You think if that sign said, happy Easter, come join us and celebrate Lamb on a spit served by the WA. No refunds, I realized. They couldn't get their 1095 back and I served them all. Is that funny or what? She took a swig of Jack. She said, you want to hear something really funny, kid? Organized religion is nothing more than a hoax. The only reason I exist is to instill fear in the masses. Because without fear in the masses, how can you control them? You.
Pardon me, I couldn't resist. But I know he's great because he told me so, and he did so with a confidence that I recognize as true. And here he is for you. David, blah, blah, blah.
I can't really hear. Is the guitar loud enough? Yeah? Is the guitar loud enough? Melissa?
Yeah.
Put the mic. Mic the amp.
We're trying to gain up.
get out, but I'm still engulfed by you. And I feel the swipes of the ceiling fan. Like a sickle, it cuts me where I stand. You got me on this wheel. Come on, you're not the only one. You tied a chain to my heel. Come on, you're not the only one. I tried my hardest to stay fit. Come on, you're not the only one.
That's all I'm gonna play. Thank you, Anna Broom. Happy anniversary. Thank you, everybody, for having me.
I know who is strong and capable in this audience, but I need you now. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pull this piano a little bit further, farther up on the stage. Come on, men. Brad Wallace, I know you're strong. You pushed it before. Jason. He's gone. All right, let's push this a little bit on. While the men do that,
just bring it this way.
I want to talk about the final act of this evening. There's a reason she's the final act. She's one of my best friends. I will say that about her because she calls me back when I need her to. She's smart and she's kind. And she all lines embrace like long-lost lovers once separated by sour traditions and gray concrete tombs. Goodbye to dancing daffodils and a romantic who sang to himself until dawn. My heart belongs to a red wheelbarrow where so much depends. Winter, spring transcends. Is that all I get? Thank you for coming tonight. Please enjoy Colette Vaughn.
Down. Where are we? Okay. Just park it. I love you. Oh my gosh. Congratulations for the 1 year, by the way. That's amazing. I remember the first Anna Broom Room show that I saw, and that's when I knew that I wanted to be good friends and hear everything you have to say and just listen. Because you're amazing. And I don't think enough people tell you that. See, you made me cry all my shit off. I had to do it back. This is really loud. I'm going to stand back here. So usually I do music for you guys. But I write quite a bit. And so I thought this was an appropriate place to start sharing some of that. Because usually it's just me and very select people if I decide to share it. This doesn't really have a title, and I think that's okay. Work it out. All right. Let me tighten this.
Can we all see her?
It doesn't matter, because I have a little thing about it.
Can we get a light on her?
One thing that happens in the music industry is that you're under the will of your listeners, and as any artist, as any performer, and we tend to manifest ourselves as to be little puppets unless you have the strength to not let that happen, and all too often it does. I'm a fool without a line. I'm a fool for your belly. I'm a fool for your love. I wanna make this plain. Oh, I know you're faded. Wanna make this plain? Oh, I know I'm fading. But stay, don't close your hands. Caught in this pool, held in your eyes. Caught like a without a line. Stay open. Stay open. Stay open. Teacher was sick of it and I was sick of it, and so she said, write a song of happy and incorporate trampoline, and I was so mad. And it took me a really long time to actually like this song, but now I really do. And so one of many things tonight is this is for you, Anna. It's kind of weird to finally sit still for a moment, like I found a new way again. And I can't wait to play again so I can jump into the sky. Let my troubles pass me by. Let my hair bounce all around. Feel the weight lays off the ground. Doing as I please. No inhibitions holding me. No inhibitions hold me on my trampoline into the wind. Feels great to be a broom room again. Blowing bubbles with my garment. We paint outside the lines. Whoever's over there, well, you know you did just fine. Follow me deeper. Follow me down a little deeper. Take your hand and say goodbye. follow me down a little farther. Take my hand, oh, you're mine. Follow me down into the darkness. Take a kiss and say goodbye. The best legs I've ever seen. I don't even know. I don't even know. I can't even.
Don't talk about what you know,
Jason. Or don't know. Okay. So again, I think this whole show is about you and what you're able to bring together. Because this is an amazing, refine it. Reject it. I deny your definition. I intend to be true to my journey. And though my journey will evolve through dirt roads, cobblestone paths, muddy forests, and ambiguous terrain, my heart will be light in knowing that it has harmonies with each step and each step right. I intend to support others in trusting their paths, and I intend to leave others better than how they were found. I intend to be.
Thank you to Fannie Mayfield, who's no longer here, but what a wonderful tribute. Thank you to Colette Bott, to everyone who supports the Brew Room and has been a part of this experience for the last year. You are my heart, and thank you for giving so much to everyone through your talent, through your soul, through everything that makes you who you are. I appreciate you. I appreciate you being a part of my life and everyone else's. I thank you for the gift. Go and be peaceful. Have a wonderful evening. Get home safe. Thank you to Jason Pippin for his beautiful piece of painting tonight.